Let's discuss about some of the terminologies used for operational amplifier. So the first terminology that we are going to discuss is known as open loop gain. So open loop gain is defined as the ratio of output voltage to input voltage when no feedback is used. So you might be wondering about what is this output voltage, what is this input voltage, and what is this ratio. So basically it's nothing. So suppose if I have an operational amplifier, something like this, this is non-inverting, this is inverting, and suppose I applied some voltage at this terminal. So let's say the voltage is V in, then output V out is the output voltage, and since I'm not feeding some part of the output to input, it is known as open loop. So I'm not using any feedback. So the gain will be equal to V out divided by V in. And I'm going to use V in since there are two terminals. V in will be the difference between the input voltage, where V plus is the voltage applied at non-inverting terminal minus the voltage applied at inverting terminal. So basically I'm going to take the difference between the inverting and non-inverting terminals. That will be my V in. Now suppose the case is something like this. I have applied, let's say V plus is equal to 10 volt and V minus is equal to 9.9 volt, and as a result I'm going to get output voltage of, let's say, 100 volt. It's a fictitious example. So what will be my gain? So the gain will be equal to 100 volt divided by V plus. V plus is 10 volt minus 9.9 volt. So that would be equal to 100 divided by 0.1, which is equal to 1000. The value similar to this or more than this is usually common in operational amplifier. So when we discuss about the properties of operational amplifier, you will realize that the open loop gain of operational amplifier is actually ideally is infinite. So the gain of operational amplifier is very, very large. So that's what open loop gain is. And if I'm going to use feedback in the circuit, that time it will be known as closed loop gain. So what are the values of closed loop gain that we will be discussing when we discuss about the application of this operational amplifier? The second terminology that we'll be needing is input bias current. Now suppose I have this operational amplifier, this is non-inverting terminal, this is inverting terminal, this is output terminal, and with respect to ground, this V output is zero. Even if this output voltage is zero, it might arise that some amount of current may be flowing through this inverting and non-inverting terminal. Let me call it as I minus and this as I plus. Some amount of current might be flowing through the inverting and non-inverting terminal when output voltage is zero. Then the input bias current is defined as I plus plus I minus divided by 2, the average current flowing through the input terminals of operational amplifier when output voltage is zero is known as input bias current. Obviously, for ideal case, if output is zero, there should be no current flowing through the input devices. So ideally, this I bias has to be equal to zero. The third thing that we are going to do is input offset current. Again, the same logic we are going to use. When V out is zero, some amount of current might be flowing. When V out is equal to zero, some amount of current may be flowing through a non-inverting and inverting terminal. Difference in this amount of current, so I plus minus I minus, is called as I offset, input offset current. So the difference of the current flowing through in inverting and non-inverting terminal when the output voltage is zero is known as input offset current. The next terminology, input offset voltage. Even if we do not apply any voltage at the input terminals, the output voltage is not equal to zero. In order to make this output voltage equal to zero, we need to apply some amount of voltages at inverting and non-inverting terminals. This voltage applied to non-inverting and inverting terminal is called as input offset voltage. So input offset voltage is the voltage applied at the input terminal so that the output voltage is equal to zero. Fifth terminology that we are going to use is CMRR. CMRR is basically common mode rejection ratio. It tells about the ability of amplifier to reject common mode signal. Basically, it's the ability of amplifier to reject the noise present at the inverting and non-inverting terminal. And this same RR is defined as A differential divided by A common. So what is A differential? A differential is nothing but when different voltages are applied at inverting and non-inverting terminal. If you apply different voltages inverting and non-inverting terminal, then whatever gain you get, it is called as differential gain. And A common mode is basically when same voltages are applied at inverting and non-inverting. Operational amplifier act as a difference amplifier. Then if you apply the same voltages at the inverting and non-inverting terminal, the output has to be zero. Ideally, this common mode gain ACM is equal to zero, but in reality it is very small number. So because of that, this CMRR ideally is equal to infinite, and CMRR in practical cases will be very, very large. This is because the common mode gain is very, very small. And the last terminology that we are going to use is called as slew rate. If I have an amplifier and if I change the input voltage, let's say initially I have applied 10 volt and there is some output voltage of, let's say, 10 volt over here, and I suddenly change this particular voltage to, let's say, 11 volt, then the voltage will change to, let's say, 11 volt. After changing the input voltage, the amount of time required to change the output voltage is called as slew rate. So slew rate is the amount of time required to change the output voltage when input voltage is changed. In other words, slew rate is defined as the time rate of change of closed loop amplifier output voltage under large signal condition. So basically this and this are the same thing. You expect that as soon as I change the input voltage, the output voltage should change. So the slew rate has to be very, very large. So quickly let's discuss about the characteristic of this operational amplifier. Now the first property is the operational amplifier will have a very, very large input impedance. Second thing is that ideally the output impedance of operational amplifier is zero. Practically it is very, very small. The operational amplifier has a very, very small output impedance. So high input impedance, low output impedance. Third is, so ideally it has infinite bandwidth. Practically it has very, very large bandwidth. What is bandwidth? Bandwidth is nothing but what kind of frequency a particular device can amplify. So infinite means any frequency this particular device can amplify, which is not actually true. A very large number of frequency it can amplify, but not all the frequencies. Then operational amplifier should have input offset voltage. What is input offset voltage? It is the amount of voltage required to make the output zero. So the input offset voltage ideally has to be equal to zero. However, in practical, it's very, 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 very small amount. The fifth thing is that operational amplifier should have input bias current. What is input bias current? Input bias current is the average current flowing through the input terminals when output is zero. So this has to be ideally equal to zero. However, practically it is very, very small. The sixth property is that operational amplifier should have finite open loop gain. So the open loop gain has to be infinite. However, practically it's not true. It has a very, very large open loop gain. And moreover, this operational amplifier will have, ideally it should have, if I'm talking about CMRR, ideally it should have infinite, but it has very, very large CMRR ratio. Same goes with the slew rate as well. So these are the properties of operational amplifier. So operational amplifier should have infinite input impedance, zero output impedance, infinite bandwidth. Oh, this has to be voltage. Zero input offset voltage, zero input bias current, and infinite open loop gain and infinite CMRR. Next lecture we will be looking at the gains of the amplifier and feedback, what kind of feedback we can use in these amplifiers. So thank you for your time.